Hey, what's up guys, Miro here with another dose of Geometry Notes experiments. This time I had a good one trying to animate bird's wings flapping and control the flock formation procedural way. I don't usually animate characters, so please excuse sketchy look. And I also know that parrots don't fly in this V-shaped formation, but I didn't find any suitable free model of a swan or a goose. Okay, so let's first have a look at the formation setup and controls. Let me first hide the instances. And as you can see, the formation is basically a simple edge, and birds are being instanced on the vertices of this edge. And then with the controls, I can change the span of the formation, or its depth, or the V shape. Birds count is controlled by the subdivision level control, which is basically the level in the subdivision surface node. So if I increase it, it subdivides the edge more and more and gets more instances of the bird on the edge. And the random position control gives the formation a bit randomness, so it doesn't look aligned. So if I again hide the instances, now you can see how the formation edge or geometry looks like. And now if I turn instances back, okay, so let's have a look at the bird animation. Let's switch to weight paint mode and turn off the modifier. So I used weight paint mode to draw weight on wings to control how much are vertices affected by sine-like movement in the z-axis. So if I drag the value, I have to turn it on. So if I drag the sine value, the wing starts to flap. To prevent all wings flapping synchronized, I cheated a little bit by duplicating bird's mesh a few times, and each duplicate has its own geometry node modifier with slightly different values in the sine node. And these are the variations. But it would be cool if we could create a new random float attribute on the formation's geometry and pass that random value to each instance's sine node. Okay, that's all regarding bird animation and formation setup. Let's have fun playing with the controls now. I would like to thank you guys for watching. If you like this experiment, please give it a thumbs up. And if you don't want to miss this next GeoNotes experiment, where I will be playing around with scattering along curve objects, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. Until next time, ciao!